Hi and welcome to another episode of Find Zen with VR, hosted by Virtuous Retail and Zen Finder. I'm your host, Ranjit Babbar, and co-founder of Zen Finder. Today we're discussing a huge challenge of the new reality, which is parenting. And how do you keep your kids engaged during this period of lockdown? To help us in today's conversation, we're talking to Lajja Sanghvi, who is a developmental psychologist and the founder of Firefly Counseling Center. Interestingly, Lajja has two boys herself and a full-time job. So tell us, Lajja, how are you managing your time during this lockdown?
So Ranjit, when you talk about how I'm looking after my kids, honestly, I'm using a pretty much a mix of everything that I explained in the previous question. But I think what's really helping me is, you know, as they say, it takes a village to raise a child. So I've kind of gotten my partner, that's my husband, involved, and we're both taking turns so that we kind of get 3 days he's homeschooling the kids, he's in charge of the kids, and 3 days I'm in charge of the kids. So on the other 3 days, we get time to do all the self-care things, which I'm going to be talking about a bit later. Secondly, my mom-in-law and me have taken turns cooking, and so basically, also I think for me, this I've always been one of those parents who's wished that I had more time with my children, and I'm looking at this opportunity to just kind of snuggle a little longer, read a book. There's no stress of waking up in the morning and going to work, going to school. We're bonding beautifully as a family. So yeah, but I'm just looking at this period as a time of deep connection, fulfillment, and kind of growing together as a family, and that's what, which I know is very precious. And also I do know that eventually, 2 months down the line, maybe 6 months down the line, this period is going to get over and we're going to be back to our busy lives. So I just want to make the most of this time with my boys, and that's what helps me when I tell myself that.
Glad to know you're making most of your time, Lajja. But unfortunately, some parents feel that managing tasks at a time like this is an insurmountable task. What perspective can you offer them that makes it less of a task and more of something that they can enjoy?
Alright, so I like to use the analogy or metaphor of being in a tunnel when I think about being in this pandemic. Yes, it's literally like we're in a cold, dark, scary place, a tunnel that is taking us from life as we knew it to an unknown place, a new paradigm. And we don't know how long the tunnel is or when it will end. So it's natural for us, again, as I said, to feel like parenting our children, juggling, working from home, the household chores is all a task. But how do we work with this? How do we kind of emerge from this tunnel, being stronger, better versions of ourselves, for ourselves and for our children? The trick or the key is in changing your narrative. Your narrative is literally that little voice or that self-talk which goes on within your mind when you're looking at a particular situation. So now, instead of looking at the tunnel as a scary, dark place, look at it as a time of going within, of a time of kind of moving in and metamorphosing. It's literally like how the caterpillar goes within into the pupa and stays in that darkness before it turns into a beautiful butterfly. Come on, every one of us here at some point or the other has complained about how we don't get enough time to spend with our kids, how life is so busy, how we're not able to do the small, simple things in life that we've always wanted to do. This is the time. This is the time for you to make this into a narrative of connection, of bonding, of power and security. So what you could do is, first of all, instead of operating from your head, because the head is all out of control, move from a head space into a heart space. Move into a space of connecting and just being, of being compassionate, of being tolerant, both with your children and with yourself. So let go of perfectionism. It's okay if, you know, the homework that you're submitting is not perfect, or you've not cooked food perfectly, or maybe that work from home assignment that you have to submit is not perfect. Just do your very best and let it go. Secondly, remember that children are constantly absorbing everything. Everything we as parents and caregivers impact the kids a lot. So when we look at our kids as a task or as a chore or as a headache, guess what they become? Of course they become a headache or they become a task. That is the power of suggestion. That is the power of words. They feel like they're a task and they become a task. They become defiant, they become rebellious. And then we're in this vicious cycle of a misbehaving defiant kid and a frustrated parent. So the way to get out of this is to center yourself, to connect deep with him, to change your narrative, to make it into a narrative of power. And lastly, please remember that when this is all over, and over it will be, because it's transient, it's not permanent, there is light at the end of the tunnel. So when we're through this pandemic finally, when it's all over, when our children look back, more than remembering anything specific about the virus, what they are going to remember is the time they had with you, your attitude at home, whether you bonded with them, did you feel safe with them, how did you as a family feel during this pandemic?
Thanks for sharing that interesting analogy, Lajja. My final question to you, and most importantly, is, you know, these are challenging times that can really put a lot of stresses on relationships, especially those with your children. What advice can you offer your parents, you know, to help them kind of manage their own stresses, emotions, and frustrations so that children don't get really affected?
All right, so coming back to the analogy of being in an aircraft, imagine the cabin pressure drops in the cabin. It's important that you first put on your own mask as a parent, your own oxygen mask as a parent, then only you'll be able to help your child. So similarly, through this crisis, it's crucial and utmost important that you invest some time in self-care. And I know a lot of us are very busy and we're juggling too many things right now as we're cooking and cleaning and homeschooling and working from home. But you can definitely surely set aside 10 minutes in your morning routine and 10 minutes in your evening routine to take care of yourself, to kind of literally pause. Look at this as an opportunity to pause and to press the reset button of your life. It's an opportunity for you to emerge as a stronger, more empowered, more resilient version of you. And trust me when I say this, when you walk your talk, your children follow suit. They kind of emulate you. So if you are firm and grounded, if you're living a holistic, balanced life during this period of crisis, if you're making the most of this crisis, your children automatically are going to copy because they have mirror neurons in their brain. They are most influenced by their parents and their caregivers. So instead of forcing them to exercise, you get onto that yoga mat, put on that workout video, start exercising. Invest some time every day in meditating, doing pranayams, deep breathing. There's tons of stuff available. So many organizations and companies have made their programs free. Read good books. Journal your feelings. When it feels like it's becoming too overwhelming, just take pen and paper, write, because when you're writing, you're literally pouring it out of your subconscious mind. You're letting all that energy go into paper and then just burn it. It's a very, very powerful exercise. I do it all the time when I'm feeling overwhelmed. There are so many resources available on the internet. If this is the time to take those self-help courses and classes that you always wanted to take, that you couldn't take. So go ahead, sign up for that program on Udemy, Coursera. There are so many, many websites. Very important. Spend some time every day praying and meditating. I think most importantly, this crisis has kind of forced us to acknowledge and accept that there is a higher power out there in the universe. It's time for us to connect to Source, to connect to the universal energy and tap into it and use it to cleanse our mind, body, and even our spirit. Lastly, please remember that there are going to be days. It's like it's a cycle of day and night. So there are going to be days when you're feeling pretty happy, you feel like you have it all together, you're being productive. So work through those excitedly. But when the lows come, and they will, there are going to be periods of lows, when you feel like you're a mess, like you feel like you're falling apart, be gentle with yourself in those days. Work through the lows gently. If need be, connect and seek professional help. There are many mental health helplines, counseling services are available. Connect to a mental health specialist. Also talk to your loved ones. Schedule Zoom sessions with your family and friends. Make the most out of this crisis, being gentle with yourself, investing in yourself, reading good books, kind of. Also, you can just let loose and have some fun. Yeah, so just make sure that you're taking good care of yourselves. And if you do that, It's going to do wonders for your kids as they kind of look at you, emulate you, and they feel safe, and your home feels like a safe space to be in.
Thank you so much, Lajja, for that insightful discussion. I'm sure our viewers have got a lot to think about from this. That's all the time that we have. If you'd like to reach out to Lajja, you can do so. We've shared her details in the description below. Thank you for joining us on this episode, and stay tuned for many more episodes to come.